Good morning, everyone. That's right. We are getting very excited about the cherry blossom, which is this beautiful pink flowery tree thing that we've got behind me. Now, there are over 200 different types of cherry blossoms at really only one Sydney Cherry Blossom Festival, which is in Auburn, New South Wales, and that's where we are this morning. Now, we've got a very special guest coming up a little later, but first we're going to talk to the man who makes it all happen, the man who's not afraid to wear a fluoro pink vest thing on television. Paul, good morning to you.
Thanks for having me. Thanks for coming out, guys. Yeah. Thanks for seeing the festival.
That's no problems at all. Now, Paul, tell me, how long does it take for these things to grow and leave? Because it's quite quick, isn't it?
Yeah, so these flowers will only be around for the next 2 weeks or so. Mm-hmm. Weather dependent, obviously, but they peak flowered started this week. Yep. And so they'll hang around for another week or so, and then they'll be gone for the year.
Yeah. So quick show's a good show, isn't it, for here?
Exactly right, yeah. Especially for us. We get a lot of people through for the festival, so... Yeah, it's really nice.
Yeah. Is this your favourite flower?
Yeah.
Yep, good. That's right. Right answer, Paul. That's exactly right. You don't love any other flower apart from this one?
No, this is exclusively my favourite flower.
Yeah. And this is a special Australian one, isn't it?
This one is suited to Sydney's climate more so than the Japanese one. This is our Prunus bleriana. Uh-huh. And yeah, it's a perfect selection for Sydney's climate.
Yeah. And is that a different genus to the Japanese one?
Different species, the same genus. So they're a Prunus tree, but Prunus bleriana.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I didn't understand a word you just said.
Yeah, well, it's technical, but it's accurate.
Yeah, no, true.
Don't look at it.
I have no doubt, Paul. Thank you so much.
No worries
fantastic.
At all.
Thank you, Paul. Now, the big special guest we've got now is, of course, Hello Kitty. It's Miss Kitty here. How are you, Miss Kitty there? Hello there, darling. Now, we've got Brooke here as well, because Miss Kitty gets so excited about cherry blossoms that she just can't bring herself to talk. So, Brooke, what can we expect from Miss Kitty here?
Miss Kitty. So, you can visit Miss Kitty in her pop-up party, which is under the wedding pavilion.
Yep.
You can get a temporary tattoo.
Yep.
You can also get nail art. Oh. And you can also get a free donut to decorate.
That is amazing. And Miss Kitty is here every single day?
She's only here today and Saturday and Sunday.
Yeah, great. Well, I was just testing you there. I've researched beforehand. That's fantastic. Now, Kitty, are you having a great time here at the Cherry Blossom Festival? I'm going to mic you anyway.
Yes.
You are a very, very pretty pussy. Very well. Thank you, Brooke. Thank you so much, Miss Kitty.
The scent of cherry blossoms isn't the only thing filling the air at Auburn Botanical Gardens today. Robbo, what else have you found to eat?
Well, konnichiwa again, Sarah Harris, and welcome back to the Cherry Blossom Festival here at Auburn in New South Wales, as you mentioned there. Now, he was a big hit earlier on in the show, so we thought we'd bring back that expert analysis and information goldmine that is Paul. Paul, welcome back to the show again.
Thanks for having me back. I've always wanted to be a minor celebrity, so thank you.
You're doing it today. You're very, very popular. Now, we understand that Auntie Marilyn actually noticed that we spelt your name wrong a little bit earlier. Is just a quick shout-out to Auntie Marilyn.
Hi, Auntie Marilyn. How are you? Thanks for watching.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching Studio 10.
Okay. All right, you're getting too good at it. Actually now, Paul. So let's talk about the food here, because there's over 20 food vendors who are going to be here across the course of the festival, which ends on the 26th, so you've got to get involved. We've got some of that food here. Is this your favourite kind of food, Paul?
This is my favourite type of food exclusively.
Yeah, lovely. Okay, well, what's your favourite here? What can you point out to us?
Well, I mean, the coffee in the cone looks fantastic with some fairy floss on the top. Anything pink, really, goes with my vest.
Yeah.
This pink bun at the front here looks fantastic.
I beg your pardon?
The pink bun.
Oh, bun.
I said bun. At the front here looks fantastic, and the creme brulee. I love anything sweet, really.
Yeah. Well, that's why we love you, because you're very sweet, aren't you?
Thank you, yeah.
Are you flirting with
a little taste there?
Okay, sure.
I don't know who's flirting with who here, actually, Paul. Who would you say?
I'm happily married, thank you.
Happily married.
Thanks for noticing. Married,
yeah, okay. Great. Well, do you have a little taste of this?
Okay, sure.
All right, let's see if we can't have a Lady in the Tramp moment.
Okay.
How about that? Isn't that nice?
That's all right. That's all right.
Nice. All right. Do you like that one? This is a Harajuku dog, isn't it? Now, you got your hands full.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, real good.
How's that?
Probably the best Harajuku dog I've ever had.
Yeah, I couldn't say it better myself. Now, as we mentioned, there are 20 food vendors and also so many activities that are happening across the festival. Paul, can you tell us what else we can expect here?
Sure, I can. I'll just swallow this food.
Okay, all right.
We've got Stadium Sumo right ahead of us here. They're a hit every year.
Yep.
But the main feature of the festival is the flowers, the cherry blossoms.
Yeah, which are your favourite flower, right?
Which are exclusively my favourite flower.
Yes, I believe every word that's coming out of your mouth.